lovely to have you with us. You wrote Tower Block. How does it feel to be closing out the Film 4 Fright Fest?
It's really exciting. I feel really greedy. I feel like I bribed the four festival organisers, which I haven't, because I'm a writer, so I don't have any money. But it's really, really exciting. I've had three films made and released in my career, and they've all premiered at Fright Fest. So I'd be quite happy if that happened every single time I made a film, even though it was a rom-com. Just make them watch it anyway.
Does the festival have a special place in your heart, then?
Absolutely, yeah. I've been coming here for over 10 years. All my films have been here. I know like 60% of the audience. It's just, you know, something I've always been an audience member here, so it's like coming home. This is my festival.
And let's talk about the movie. For fans who are looking forward to seeing it, can you tell us the story?
I won't say very much because I don't want to spoil it for anybody. It's best to go in not knowing anything. Basically, a sniper is keeping people trapped on the top floor of a tower block building with a sniper rifle, and he won't let them leave, and they don't know why. And that's all I'll say.
What was your inspiration when writing this story?
Just all of the things that can go wrong. I mean, I spent all of my day, if I'm walking around town, I think, don't walk over there because that guy might be a serial killer. Don't stand too close to the edge of the tube platform because somebody might be running past and want to push me onto the tracks. And just, I'm always thinking the worst case scenario, and this is just one of those things. I was watching another movie at Fright Fest a few years ago, and I thought the killer was about to do something. And he didn't, and I thought that would actually be quite a horrible thing to do in a horror movie, and that was pretty much this. So it was born here, and it will live and die, possibly die here. I don't know.
You mentioned sort of your own personal paranoia. Is that something that informs all your writing?
Oh yeah, yeah. I mean, everything I write, it's all born out of insecurity and fear and paranoia, need to be loved, revenge, hatred, bitterness. It's all, I get it all out on the page. So that I'm not a serial killer in real life.
What about casting? What do you think the cast members brought to their particular roles?
There's some challenging roles in this, and it would be very easy to kind of do a one-note performance and just kind of treat it on one level. But they all brought so many more layers to it, and just kind of they lifted them all off the page. So you know, there's some characters that you may not initially think are sympathetic, but you actually grow to love them. And you know, a lot of that is intended, but a lot of that they bring to their roles.
Obviously, you say you've been coming to Fright Fest for years and years. What does the horror genre mean to you personally?
It's something I've always loved ever since I was a kid. I don't know, I mean, it's only recently I've started kind of trying to intellectualise it and wonder why I like all these horrible, sick, twisted things. And it's not that I enjoy seeing people in pain or tortured or killed or anything. It's that I enjoy seeing them get out of it or try to get out of it. Or it's kind of a dry run for things that might go wrong in your life. It's kind of a safe, controlled environment to experience all these terrible things. And at the end, it's okay. It's just a movie and you can go back home.
But you've written for much more sort of family-friendly things, Doctor Who, Torchwood, stuff like that. Do you still try and bring your own stamp, that sort of paranoia we were talking about, to things like that?
Oh, yeah, yeah. I mean, in every story, you try and kind of think, what's the maximum conflict? What can go wrong for these characters so that they can try and escape? And in all of those, even the family-friendly ones, I've killed a lot of people. I mean, you know, I didn't set off the volcano in Pompeii, but it went off, and 20,000 people died. You know, maybe I saved a family, but it was just a token amount, really.
And are there any projects you're working on at the moment you can tell us about?
There's one that should be filming next year called Silent Night of the Living Dead, which is a Christmas zombie movie. It's sort of Gremlins meets Fulci. That should be filming next year. And I've got a few other different types of movies that are sort of in the pipeline, but we'll see which one goes first. So I'm open to offers while I'm still cheap.
And finally, do you have a message for horror fans?
Yes, keep watching horror, keep going to see good horror. I'm not necessarily saying mine, you know, that's not for me to say, but if you go and see good original horror movies and support low budget, you know, unique original movies, then more of them will get made. If you don't go and see them, then they won't make any money and nobody will make any more, and you'll just get stuck with endless remakes of Halloween and all, you know, just remakes and sequels, and you know, they only keep making them because you go and see them. So put your money where your mouth is, don't go and see the crap, and go and see the good stuff, or I'll come and find you and kill you.